In this video, let us look at a video capture and viewer tool in Linux. It's called GUVCVIEW. Its main page describes it as it is a simple GTK plus interface for capturing and viewing video from devices supported by the Linux UVC driver. It fully supports video for Linux too, so it should work with any driver that supports this API. So it should pretty much work most of the latest webcams, but you should make sure before purchasing a webcam that it supports Linux installation, to be installed on Linux. So depending upon the capabilities of your webcam, the GUVC viewer will display different options. The GUVC viewer can be opened from applications, sound and video, and GUVC view. If it is not already installed on your computer, you can easily install it from the Ubuntu package manager or the Synaptics package manager. From the Ubuntu software center, it is called. And it could be installed on any of the Linux distributions. So this is the GUVC viewer controls panel. As you can see, as my webcam supports several features, they are all displayed here. You can select the device, you can select the frame rate from 5 frames to 30 frames per second. You can change the resolution of the video. It supports different screen resolutions. You can choose the camera output. It also allows you to capture a still image and save it. So you can select the default name given to the image. Whenever the image is captured, it will give a default name. In this case, it gives the name image.png, and if you click on the capture image button, it will capture whatever is in front of the camera and then save it in your home folder under the name image.jpg or .png or .bmp, whatever file extension you have selected. So here you can select different image formats: JPEG, BMP, PNG and RAW. And again, you can give a name to the video file for the video capture. Video capture can be initiated by pressing the capture video button. Then you can save, you can open them. The captured videos are by default stored under your home folder. The default name is captured.avi. AVI is the format that I have selected for saving the videos. Now again, you have an option to select different video codecs. You have MJPG, YUY2, RGB, MPEG video, Flash video, Windows Media Video, MPEG2, MP4, MPEG4 and H.264. So these are the different video codecs, and there are two video formats available, Matroska and AVI, depending upon the video codec that you have selected. There are some video filters that you can apply. There are not many, but there are a few, such as the mirror that will flip the video horizontally. It can invert, make it upside down. You can turn it to a negative. You can make the image monochrome. And then there is some effect like being behind a glass. Then there is a particle effect. It appears something like bubbles popping out. Now we will look at the image controls. The first one is brightness, contrast, saturation, white balance, gain, power line frequency, white balance, temperature, sharpness, backlight compensation, exposure. There are four different modes: auto mode, manual mode, shutter priority mode, and aperture priority mode. So these things will depend upon the webcam that you have purchased. If the webcam supports these features, they will be displayed here. So it's quite advanced. And then you also have the option to record audio. And of course, it displays whatever is in front of the webcam right on your desktop. So in this video tutorial, I'm not recording the video using the GUVC viewer, but I am simply displaying this video on my desktop, and I am recording this video using the X11 grab in FFmpeg. It's a simple command line that allows you to use the FFmpeg to do the screen recording. You can find these commands on many websites on the internet. Just look for the FFmpeg help files, help pages. So what am I doing is here is I am first recording the video in AVI format, and after that I am using FFmpeg to convert it to FLV in order to upload it on YouTube. So that is for the video capturing. And then for video editing, you can use a software called KDEN Live. It says it is a non-linear video editor for KDE. I have been able to successfully edit the videos. It works pretty well. And then for your image organizing needs, if you want a photo album like software, you may be aware of Google Picasa. You may have used it on Windows, but now Google Picasa is available for Linux. The Picasa 3 for Linux is in the beta stage, and it is available for downloads. So for those who do not know what Picasa is, I will simply read from the Google site. It allows you to organize, manage your photos in one place and find photos you forgot you had. You can edit, do some basic editing, eliminate scratches and blemishes, fix red eye, crop and more, create, turn photos into collages, slideshows and more, share, upload seamlessly to Picasa web albums. If you have a Gmail account, you will be able to access the Picasa web albums. You can upload your photographs. So after installation, Picasa creates a small desktop launching icon in the on your desktop. If you click on it, it will start the Picasa album. It's a pretty neat software. If you need something like this to find out where your photographs are on your hard disk, it will display all the names of different folders, and in the left panel and in the right panel you can see the thumbnail view of all the images that are present in different folders. It's a pretty neat utility for you to organize your photographs. So I'm happy that Picasa is available for Linux also. And then there are the useful Picasa features. So you can send these images to your web album, you can email them, you can print them, you can directly post it to your blog or create a collage or export. So I think that's a brief view of some of the essential tools for you to capture a video or a still image from your webcam and then organize, save it or edit the video. I will end it here. Thank you very much.